Welcome to Broadway. Tonight's show stars two of the brightest teams in the East. Stage left, a top-billing offense starring Alexander Barkov.
Barkov to the backhand, what a goal!
Jonathan Huberdeau.
Shoots and scores! Jonathan Huberdeau remains red hot.
And Anthony Duclair.
Moving in, Duclair scores! The shoot gets it! It's showtime in South Florida.
Stage right, the rising star, Igor Shesterkin.
Shut down by Shesterkin.
Whose performance feels reminiscent of a leading man.
How did he stop those shots? Oh, my goodness.
So take your seats while the players hit their marks. The O.
What time? They score again.
Versus Igor.
Down low. Oh, what a shot you made.
One night only. Panthers, Rangers. Next on ESPN Plus.
Welcome to ESPN Plus Hockey Night, presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. It is the Florida Panthers taking on the New York Rangers at the world's most famous arena. Two of the best teams that the NHL has to offer, and right at the top of the standings. Brought to you by Crypto.com. We will find these Florida Panthers with 69 points, lurking not far behind. Fourth best in the East, the Rangers with 62 points. Bob Wischusen here with Brian Boucher. AJ Malesko joining us ringside as well. Basically, welcome to Brian Boucher's nightmare. Right? Like trying to watch these two teams play goal against them. Good luck.
All right, if you like offense, this is the game you want to watch. The Panthers, a deadly team, 5-on-5. The Rangers rely on their power play to kickstart their offense. A goaltender's nightmare.
AJ, how do you slow the Panthers down?
Well, that's a great question, and that's why we're here and not head coaches of these NHL teams. Incredible offense. They're creative. They're deep. They get offense up and down their lineups. They lead the league with 190 goals scored, 108 of them since December. Again, leading the league in all categories. You know, they think they can outscore any defensive errors they make, but that's one thing their opponents are looking for, more loose defensive.
Well, Chris Kreider right now tied for the league lead in goals scored with Leon Draisaitl, and he is scoring goals with a backstop behind him at Igor Shesterkin, Boosh, that might be the best in the NHL as well.
Yeah, and for me, I think Igor Shesterkin, I think, is a guy that I could consider to be MVP of this hockey team. And there's no disrespect to Adam Fox or Chris Kreider, but the reality is that Shesterkin has been very good at a time when the Rangers early on in the season were outchanced regularly. They've cleaned that up, but when you watch Shesterkin, you certainly know that you're going to get a top-notch performance from their goaltender. I expect him to be very good tonight. I hope he got a good night's sleep. This Panthers team is deadly offensively.
Regina Wilson of the FDNY, set with the anthem.
Tonight's colors are presented by the Fire Department of New York. And here to sing the Star Spangled Banner from the Fire Department of New York, please welcome back Regina Wilson.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight wore the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red the bombs bursting in air, came through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet
of the FDNY with the national anthem firing up Madison Square Garden. And Brian Boucher set to look at our goaltending matchup, and we talked about it. Igor Shesterkin. He has been tremendous all season long, certainly in the Vezina conversation.
And there's no doubt about it, and he's looking for his 22nd win on the season. If you want a guy that is on top of his game, this is your guy. In his last nine games, he is 8-1, looking to finish strong before a couple of weeks off during the All-Star Olympic break. And then at the other end, Spencer Knight, the 20-year-old, grew up a New York Ranger fan. You can bet that he's excited to be here at MSG. Grew up just down the road in Darien, Connecticut, looking for his 10th win of the season.
The backup goaltender with Sergei Bobrovsky going last night, second half of a back-to-back and a long break. So Knight gets the start. And Andrew Brunette was in a difficult situation at the start of the season, taking over for Joel Quenneville, but has done an exemplary job. Still the interim head coach. Maybe we remove that tag before too long.
Now, I would say with the way he's got this team playing, that interim tag will be coming off. He's done a great job, a guy who's been around the game of hockey for a long, long time. He's got his team playing very well offensively.